Assalamu alaikum. We will show you in this Mediaket tutorial how to configure the TP-Link TD-W8901G modem as a bridge, as a router, secure the wireless network, port forwarding, and how to obtain a static IP address. In this part, we will show you how to set up the modem as a bridge and how to secure wireless network. Type the following IP: 192.168.1.1 in the address bar of your browser. And click here to access the modem interface. Type here username admin and password admin. And click OK button. Click on Quick Start menu. Click on Run Wizard button. Click on Next button. Click to open the drop-down menu, select your time zone and click Next. Check bridge mode option. Click Next. You enter here the VPI and VCI of your internet service provider. In our case, our provider is JWeb, VPI 0 and VCI 38. You leave the connection type as it is. And click Next. Check this case to activate the Wi-Fi. Give a name to your Wi-Fi. And check No, if you want to make your Wi-Fi invisible. Click to open the drop-down menu. And select the authentication type. And click Next. Here you type the password to protect your wireless network. Use a strong password composed of letters, numbers and special characters. And click Next. Click Next again. And finally click on Close button. We have finished this part. In this part, we will show you how to set up the modem as a router. Type the following IP: 192.168.1.1 in the address bar of your browser. Press Enter or click here to access the modem program. Type here username admin and password admin. And click OK button. Click on Quick Start menu. Click on Run Wizard button. Click on Next button. Click to open the drop-down menu, select your time zone and click Next. Check this option to select router mode and click Next. Type here the username and password for internet connection provided by your internet service provider. Beware of errors. You enter here the VPI and VCI of your internet service provider. In our case, our provider is JWeb, VPI 0 and VCI 38. You leave the connection type as it is. And click Next. Check Now if you want to make your Wi-Fi invisible. Click Next. Click Next again. And finally click on Close button. We have finished this part. We will show you in this part, port forwarding for application servers and games. Click on Advanced Setup. Then click on NAT. Click on Virtual Server. You type here the application name, for example Emule. Select All for Protocol. You need to know the application's ports you want to configure. Each application has its own ports. Type here your local network IP. Click on the Save button to save the changes. Now, we will set up a game example, a server for COD4. Select 2 from index. We are going to do the same procedure as the Emule application, except that the ports are not the same. Click on Save button to finish. In this part, we will show you how to get a static IP address. Click on Access Management menu. Click on DDNS submenu. Visit these websites. opt-in-dns.com or noip.com, and create a subdomain to use it as a static IP address. Here is the domain we created by registering on dndns.com. This is email used to register on dndns.com. Type here the dndns.com account username and password. And finally, click on the Save button to save the changes. We have finished. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to comment, click on like and subscribe. Mediaket shows you how to change the DNS servers in TP-Link TD-W8901G modem. Type the following IP and hit Enter key. Type here, username, admin, and default password, admin. Click OK. Click on Interface Setup menu. And click on LAN submenu. Click on DNS Relay drop-down menu, and select Use User Discovered DNS Server Only. Here, we have used the Google DNS servers. You can use other DNS servers that we have listed on the right, and there are more. It's up to you to choose and test. Click on Save to finish. We have finished. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Mediaket shows you how to backup and restore your modem configuration. The modem is TP-Link TD-W8901G. First part, how to create a backup file of your modem configuration. Type the following IP, 192.168.1.1, and press Enter key. Type here, username, admin, and default password, admin. Use your password, if you have already changed the default password, and click OK. Click on Maintenance menu. And click on Firmware submenu. Click on ROM file save button to save your backup file. And click OK. Click OK again. Create a new folder in your desktop, where you want to save your configuration backup file, and rename it. For example, use your modem router model name. Click on Save to finish. The modem configuration backup file has been saved successfully. If there is a problem, you can restore the modem configuration from this backup file. This is what we will do, in the second part. Second part, how to restore a backup file of your modem configuration. Connect to the modem as it showed in the first part. Click on Maintenance menu. And click on Firmware submenu. Click on Browse to select the backup file. Select ROM0 file and click Open. And finally click on the upgrade button to start the restore. Please be patient, this will take a moment. Nice, the modem configuration has been successfully restored. We have finished. Don't forget to comment, like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.